my book is trying to put facts and to put history and to put data in one of the most controversial issue in history, which is the issue of inequality and unequal income and wealth. And you know, this is an issue about which people have been fighting for centuries, in particular during the 20th century with very violent fight between capitalism and communism, etc. Instead of looking at only one country, I look at over 20 countries in the world, and I look at wealth and not only at income. So I can look, you know, I study the distribution of who owns what and not only who earns what. Societies of the past were really based on wealth, in the sense that inequality was primarily inequality between those who own wealth and those who only own their labor. One of the economic laws, to the extent that there are laws in economics, is indeed R bigger than G, so the rate of return to capital tends to be bigger than the growth rate. It means that whatever wealth was accumulated in the past is now being recapitalized faster than the growth rate of the economy, which is also the growth rate of labor income. And therefore, basically, you better start with some initial wealth. You know, if you just try to enter the game only with your labor income, well, this has to be a very high labor income. Now, there is another type of society and another type of model of inequality that has been emerging particularly in the United States over the past few decades, where you have a huge rise of the top labor income and in particular the top compensation that managers in large corporations are getting. Now, of course, the problem is that if you are neither a top manager or a top inheritor, then you lose on both grounds. So the good news is that about the future is that when we read the past in this way, we can see that, you know, there are several possible futures. You know, it's not as if inequality has to rise indefinitely or inequality will reduce naturally. You know, there's nothing natural in the history of income and wealth distribution, and there's nothing natural in the history of economic facts more generally. I think we need to reopen, you know, the black box of inequality in our industrial societies, and to look very, you know, in a very crude way at what the market economy is able to do and what the market economy is not able to do. So the market economy is great at producing new wealth, but sometimes it can be quite bad at generating a distribution of wealth that is equitable in the long run. So, you know, it's great to have entrepreneurs, it's great to have new wealth being formed, but this has to be compatible with the size of the world economy. You know, if the top of the distribution is rising 3 or 4 times faster than the world economy, if you have that during the next 50 years, basically all the wealth will belong to a very small international elite. And basically there will be no wealth middle class anymore. And there will be a level of inequality which is simply not compatible with our democratic and meritocratic values.